This is a basic collared graphic that I made in Mojo. This is the same graphic, but it's not actually motion tracking with the woman. Now we've got the same graphic again, but this time it is motion tracked. Would you like to learn how to do it? Well, let's stop for a second. There's not a keyframe in sight, and it actually wasn't done in LumaFusion, and I'm going to show you how to do it right now. Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another video editing tutorial. Now today, we're going to look at motion tracking, because one of the features that I lost out on when I moved from the Adobe Creative Suite and Final Cut onto the iPad full time is the ability to motion track, especially things like 3D motion tracking and that. But I knew I could do it manually using keyframes in LumaFusion. And for the type of motion tracking that I do, which is for callouts and showing up little details and things like that, and adding graphics and having them follow somebody, like their name and things like that, it's pretty much easy to do within LumaFusion. But if you know me well, you know I'm always looking for a quick and easy way to do things. And today I'm going to show you how to motion track using a new app called Node Video. Welcome to Node Video. Now when I say it's a new app, what I'm actually saying is it's a new app to me. It's been out for a wee while now, but there isn't a huge amount of video tutorials on YouTube at the moment. So that's why I want to demo this for you and let you see one of the features of many that it can actually do. So the first thing we need to do is we're in Pro Mode, tap on New, and this takes us to our canvas. Then we're going to tap on the red and white plus, go to our media, go to video, and we're then going to load up the video clip that we need. I'm going to choose this first one of the girl, or woman I should say. Tap on that. The first thing you need to do is just play the video through, because unlike LumaFusion, this thing renders on the go. So you just need to give it a run through. And once you've got a full green bar at the bottom, things will play nice and smoothly. The other thing you need to be aware of is wherever you apply an effect, it starts at the point in the timeline. So if you want to be at the beginning, make sure you go to the beginning of the timeline. So we'll just slide that back there. Right. What we're going to do now is we're going to bring in another video clip. Before we do that, we will just rename this video, I think. And we'll call it Women Walking Towards Camera. Tap done. And we're then going to bring in another video. This time we're going to go to this clip here. And this is my call out. Just let it play through fully. And then just take the playhead right the way back to the beginning. And the first thing that we're going to do is obviously key out the chroma. We go to plus, and we then go to mask. Then we go to chroma key and boom, that's it done for us. Simple as that. Play it again. And as you can see, it's not tracking to anything specific at the moment. Now what I want to do now is go back to the beginning and go to the transform option up here and then just move the graphic over. I'll just play it through a little bit so I can see what's going on. I want to position it roughly just at her shoulder. Now this might need a little bit of tweaking, but this is the initial start point that you want to work with. Once you've got that, take your playhead back to the beginning and go back to your woman walking layer. We then want to tap this little plus symbol below the audio again, and this time we're going to go to tracker. And as you can see, actually, there's a lot of things you can do in here. You can color grade, you can do animation, you can mask, you can apply effects. Today we're going to use the tracker, but we'll come back to some of these other effects and techniques at a later date. But let's do the tracker today. So you've got two different trackers. You've got stabilizer, which I'm going to have to play with to see what it's like compared to the other stabilizing software that I use on the iPad. But today we're going to go for motion tracker. Now the first thing you have to do is again, make sure your playhead is at the beginning, and then you press analyze. Now when you do this, you need to also move this little rectangular box around, and I'm going to lock it onto, see that crease on our shirt? I'm going to lock it onto there. Now the reason for this is, when experimenting with this, I found the tracker works best if you're locking onto contrasty pixels, so something that's obviously got a kind of line edge to it. You're then going to tap analyze, and this is going to generate your tracking, and you can see the green line of the tracking movement working for us. It's kind of doing a sort of very loose loop, and then it's just going off to the left. And then once you've got that information, what you then want to do is apply video one to this tracker. So you apply to target, tap none, and you then tap video one. Then from there, tap apply, go back to the beginning, tap on root so that you're working with everything, the woman walking, video one, and the root, and press play. And you'll see now the motion tracker, not exactly tracking her, because I need to move it a little bit more, but it is tracking the middle of her top. So what we need to do again is go back to video one. We're in transform. We're just going to move the playhead along a little bit. I can see where it starts. There we go. And again, I'm just going to move it up to position here. Go back to the root, go back to the beginning, and play again. And you'll see this time it's tracking the corner of her shoulder, which is where I want it to be. Now it looks a bit janky and rough just now, but you'll see when we export it and then get it back into LumaFusion, it's actually pretty smooth. Now the other thing that you need to do is make sure that in video one, you tap on motion blur and make sure it's on. Just go with the default settings for now, and that will also smooth out the graphic and apply a little bit of motion blur as well. We'll give it one more play. And you can see because I'm only in video one, it's just moving video one. This is why we need to go back to the root to play the whole thing and the two videos together. But I just wanted to show you that. So tap on root, that selects everything. Press play again. And even though we're tracking the crease in our shoulder, I just wanted the actual wording of the callout motion tracking just to sit to the left-hand side. And there we go. Now to export, all you've got to do is just tap export, choose a resolution. Now, one of the things that's a bit restrictive is the fact that you can only output 1080p, but nearly all my videos go up on YouTube at 1080p, so I'm not too worried about that. And I'm pretty sure you could get away with scaling up to 4K if you wanted to. Now, to render this, you just tap the green play icon. Do not close the node video. And once it's done, that will automatically be saved to your Photos app. Just tap OK, and we can then go back into LumaFusion and take a look at it. We're now back in LumaFusion, and I've got the video clip loaded up on my timeline. So we'll just press the spacebar, and you can now see we've got some nice, smooth motion tracking, and we didn't need to use a single keyframe in LumaFusion. Not that that's a bad way of doing things, but it is slow and laborious sometimes. So this is a great way of being able to motion track simply and easily within your iPad in a similar fashion to how you would do it in the likes of After Effects or if you're using Apple Motion or whatever. Just give it one more run. Now I should say, download Node Video for free, but to obviously access the pro features like the tracker, you're going to have to pay a few bucks. It's not ridiculously expensive, but it's something that you've got to be aware of. So if you're wanting to do this on a professional level and you're getting paid to do it, then it's worth investing in it. If you're just doing it for fun, then have a think about whether you want to be paying for it or not, or whether you just want to go down the keyframe route. I'll give it one last play. There's the tracker smoothly tracking the woman. And there we go. Just a quick demo today to show you the features of Node Video, and we'll take another look at it and some of the more complex features that you can do in terms of masking and applying motion blurs and all sorts of different things. And I will catch you on the next video tutorial. Bye.